I wanna say to my sisters and my brother, keep the faith. When the storm flies and the wind blows, go on at a steady pace. When the battle is fought and the victory's won, we can all shout together, we have overcome. We'll talk to the Father and the Son when we make it to the promised land. We walk together, little children. We don't ever have to worry. Through this world of trouble, we gotta love one another. Let us take a fellow man by the hand, try to help him to understand. We can all be
Garcia. Grateful Dead to me. Still pretty cool though. It's real laid back. That's for sure. The ultimate garage band. The Dead. Walketh in the darkness. No bone of destruction. And I got like what looks like the ultimate studio in my garage. Not quite the ultimate. It used to be the ultimate. We don't ever have to worry. Through this world of trouble, we gotta love one another. Let us take a fellow man. It's a pretty good message in this song. Try to help him to understand. We can all be alrighty. So, it is, what's today's date? Is it the 20th or the 21st? It's Friday, December 20th, 2019. Less than 2 weeks away, we're into 2020. Perfect vision, right? Sure, Dave. So anyway, I had a special package show up today, and I'm like, you know, hey, I see TDC Radio's on here. That's great. So so I had a special package. I want to share the revealing of this package live, because I haven't even opened the box yet. Yeah, you can just feel. Where's it at? There's the box right there. Ooh, feel the power. Yes, I'm being weird tonight. The subject mostly tonight, of course, you know, it's easy for me to get off on a tangent. That's for sure. Ooh, look, a shiny thing. So, seems that we had a whole lot of quantum effects sweep across the land this past week, really revealing themselves over the past day or so. And I'll tell you what, I got one note. Let me show you this. I think you could see. Well, yeah, you could see it. I got an email from West Cleveland Original. And he said, my KJV and Matthew was back to saying, two men shall be in a field, one shall be taken and the other left. Two women shall be grinding at the mill together. Right? So, it seems some of our scriptures that have quantum affected, changed, corrupted, some are returning back to their original state. Imagine that. Anybody see any potential fallout for something like that? So we've been saying for the past couple of years that the scriptures are changing, and now they change back. Now, what I would find interesting, I'm actually looking forward to putting this to the test. taking West Cleveland's. I didn't actually go and look at my Bible. I'm taking West Cleveland's word for it. He's a trustworthy guy. And anyway, I'm looking forward to putting this to the test to see if people say, oh, yeah, it's always been that way. Not when they used to say it's always been the other way, right? Man, it would be awesome for Isaiah 11:6 to change back to the lion shall lie with the lamb. I take it to everybody. I'll tell you what, if that was to happen, folks, we all need to run out and capture people on video saying it, right? That would be quite interesting. Diana Audman, have seen what? We got the rain on the plains. The word and truth, it's supernatural, not man-made. Yes, it is supernatural. It's not man-made, these whole quantum effects. But I would suggest that Satan has always gotten mankind to do his dirty work, and those who follow after Satan. So the powers and principalities, powers of darkness, right? They've always been in league with mankind who will follow after them and to do their dirty work. In Psalm 2, it says, the kings of the earth and the rulers together plot a vain thing. And so the rulers are the fallen angels, the watchers, the holy watchers, the B'nai Elohim, the sons of God, that God put over the nations. That's a whole nother subject. We may actually kind of touch on that tonight, though. Ganna Ball. I don't think I've ever seen that name here. So hello. It looks maybe it's your first time. Bob D. What's up? Data Junkie. How you doing? Big change I noticed was when Balaam the prophet with a donkey, the word now blames Israel and not the prophet. Blames Israel. Interesting. Noahide. Yes. Christopher Levens. I've got a number of pieces on the Noahide laws. A whole bunch of pieces talking about that. That is certainly something on the horizon that's coming our way. A lot of people don't know that the Noahide laws are actually written into our laws. They slipped them in on an education bill. If you've never heard that, maybe we'll talk about that a little bit too. Tesla's enthusiasm. Hello, Mike Pagano. What's up? Holy moly donut shop. Anyway, that's pretty cool. Actually, I like that name. Bad boy channel. Bad boy, bad boy. What you gonna do? Anyway. John Roberts from Melbourne, Australia, all the way in the land that used to be down under. By the way, I have to correct myself on that statement. I had a discussion. I might have said it loud, out loud on the last gathering we had, where Paul Adams came on and gave a testimony of a vision he had. I believe that we can impact changes in our current realm. As Data Junkie, I believe, just said that it was Word and Truth that said we human beings are not causing this. It's supernatural, but we have to gain an understanding of what supernatural is, that these angels, these fallen angels and the demonic are influencing change, but they're using technologies as a conduit into this realm to affect a greater change, a more impactful change. And so they taught men technology. They gave them the information. If you read about most of our technologists, a lot of them heard voices. They were taught things from the spirit realm. CERN, for example, they talk quite a bit about hearing voices and having learned how to do the things they're doing. So that said, we can impact the changes. I'm not saying that we're creating reality. Don't read into what I'm saying. One way, certainly, is prayer. I believe the scripture says something akin to the fervent prayers of a righteous man availeth much. Right? And so we can affect change by prayer, certainly. And I hear voices, but I don't know where they're at. Oh, I see people. There they are. My daughter's bringing her friend in. I'm hearing people talk off to the side. Ooh, what's going on here? Toronto, much love. Tommy Rogers, what's up? That's right. The first Macintosh sold for $666, Rom. So anyway, where was I? Oh, us affecting change. AI, and I've said it before, I'll say it again, I'll say it. AI is legion. AI, no one knows where it came from. Nobody knows how it was made. It showed up on the scene and it writes its own code. It edits itself. It is legion. It's demonic. It interfaces with this realm through tech. Okay? But part of that tech is also in our atmosphere through the chemtrails, that aluminum and what's the daggone other stuff that's all in the chemtrails? Why is it eluding me now? Strontium, barium, right? And that's another area, by the way, that we can bind in the name of Jesus and rebuke the actions of the demonic in our atmosphere. Right, we can rebuke. Satan is called the prince of the power of the air. And those of us in Christ Jesus can pray against him. Hey, Brian, dude, I'm glad you're here. Brian Stavely in the house, folks. I'm actually going to touch on the subject that is dear. What's the antithesis to dear to his heart? Yeah. He loathes it, but it's dear to his heart. Black Tom. I bet she's getting a facial tick right now. Anyway, Stavely has turned us all on to a number of quantum effect or Mandela effect changes. And he's always on the lookout, which is great. He's the man with the plan. And dude, I'm going to show you something that you're going to love. Well, not love. Love. Something like that. Anyway, so as a matter of fact, I think Stavely had talked about yesterday. I forget. That's right. Stavely had talked about recall vectors, recent efforts. And I saw something today I want to show if I can find it. Of course, you know, anytime you go live, all the crap you got open. All right. You know what? I'm going to just show you as a little reminder real quick. If I can. Y'all remember my talks about these bands? And I can't play it. If I do, right, I'm going to get a copyright hit, okay? This is one band. See that blue screen? This is another. Check it out. Okay? Now, these bands existed, but these videos did not, okay? And these are all created, and everybody's, well, not everybody, but Captain Beefheart. Right? If I can see it. Okay. A lot of those bands, suddenly now we have on the scene AI created archival videos of these bands that never existed. Okay. Some of the bands never existed. Some of them are actual bands we all know and love. But the video that has been created is an AI concoction, okay? So I wanted to remind everybody of that. That needs to be a constant thread in the back of our minds, okay? So we need to remember that as we're processing other things that we're seeing, okay? Yes, these things are supernatural. Some are going to disagree with me. Okay, whatever. We are not ascending to another level. We are not drifting between different a myriad of dimensions. We're not. This is not a multiverse that we live in. Okay, the scripture says the beginning of wisdom is fear of the Lord. Now that fear, the word fear doesn't mean fear like you're scared, but it means that we give honor to God Most High, that we acknowledge Him in all our ways, and then He directs your paths. Okay, so look, let me find the tabs and let's see. Oh yeah, wait a minute. One thing I did want to show. Check this out. I want to show you guys something. Hopefully you can still hear me when I do this. Check this out. Can you all see this? This is the tube, the package that came. One of the listeners sent me and Awakened Saint those posters of the Terra del Fuego flat earth poster. Pretty cool, huh? So I did want to say thanks. I'm not going to say his whole name. I don't know if he wants me to call out his name. His name's Craig. And pretty cool. You know what's also very cool, though? You can make music with anything. Pretty cool. I'm a musical genius. Anyway, so that came, and since there's so much giving going around, this laptop is being given away. A woman named Jennifer is getting this laptop, and West Cleveland Original is finally going to get his hard drive with videos and his DVD set of Know Your Enemy. And the hard drive's in a box over here somewhere, or I'd show it. But anyway, so I'm going to be shipping those out sometime this week. And I just wanted to let you know, because I remember I announced the giveaways that I've been doing. I actually have given away laptops, a couple. I've received an email from one person asking me, reminding me about it today. So what's up with Black Tom? Are there some AI? Well, it's, you know, I was going to save this for towards the end. And I've never been one that likes, you know, when I buy people presents, if I buy my wife or my daughter a present, I can't hold out to give it to them. I have to give it to them like right away. I suck at that. I've never won like my mother used to do, wrap all the presents like in April for Christmas time. Yes, we celebrated Christmas in our house when I was young. Not to offend any of you who still do, but we do not celebrate Christmas or Easter in our house. No trees, right? Don't save it. I'm yawning, Sparky OG says. All right. Well, okay. Why don't we just get into that then? You know, wait a minute. Let me show some of the changes we've had, though, this week. And so what I'll do is I'll call up my history. Cool. And some really interesting changes occurred in the past few days. Let's see. This is one that's really interesting right here. It doesn't make any daggone sense. Let's see. Check this out. Mm-hmm.
While the majority of construction activity occurs in and around major urban areas to provide housing, infrastructure, and support economic growth, some buildings serve their purpose by deliberately being as far away from the hustle and bustle as possible. Seldom seen, barely known about, and hardly ever visited, these are the world's most remote buildings.
Okay, does that look like a good idea to y'all?
The smallest island in the world with a building on it, Bishop's Rock, is the westernmost point of the Scilly Archipelago and lies 70 kilometers as the men.
Now, I don't know if this is a quantum effect or not, but it's pretty daggone crazy. Pretty crazy that they would have this lighthouse sitting out in the middle of just a rock. I mean, I don't know. Doesn't make sense to me. I could be wrong, but that was an oddity to me. If anybody, I know we've got some folks from the UK that watch. Leilani, I think is her name. I forget her full name. World's biggest boy. That's what Stavely says. There is another one. If I can find it. Actually, all I have to do is find Recall Vector's piece, which was smoking. Oh, here's one of them. Yeah. Check this out. Here's Recall Vectors. Okay.
I just did this experiment in my freezer and freaked out. The water wasn't frozen, but when I poured it into my orange juice, the ice slab came straight into the water bottle and it became solidly frozen in about 3 seconds. This is a great catch. I've never seen this before.
Okay. Is that real, folks? Because that could be faked video. But if it's not, if that's real, this is also pertinent to something I've been saying for a while now, is that our what we call the material world is changing. And it's changing because they changed the way light functions and operates in our world. And they did that, firstly, by putting all the particulates in the atmosphere. And I've talked about this book before. And this is a friend of mine's book, Dr. Claire Parkinson from NASA. And she sent me a copy of this, I don't know. I want to say 12 years ago or something, whatever. Anyway, so in it, she detailed that they were talking about putting particulates in the stratosphere to block out and filter out certain frequencies of solar radiation, sunlight. Okay? NASA speak for sunlight, y'all. Okay? So, anyway, so they were already doing it then, and I didn't say anything to her. She's a NASA scientist. She's actually on a United Nations, or was, I haven't talked to her recently, on a United Nations panel of 60 worldwide climatologists who make best practices policies for global climate. So they don't actually implement the policies. They write up, they draft up what would be best practices, okay? So, yeah, you got a Gatorade out of an ice fridge and shook it. It does the same thing. So check it out. That's what Landon Pett says. Hey, welcome, buddy. So here's the thing is the way, all right, how can I explain this without getting too techie? Sunlight, light in general, drives almost everything in this world about life, right? It is what drives the engine of photosynthesis, where we get plants, where we eat plants, where we get our food. You all realize that sunlight to our skin causes our skin, our bodies, to produce vitamin D, which is important for our bones and all kinds of biological processes in our bodies that we need these things, okay? So when they started filtering light, if y'all have been watching for at least 10 years, but not even that long, a couple years, you notice that the sunlight totally changed its color, right? That the sun did not look the same anymore, okay? So look, since the sun didn't look the same anymore, some people decided that it must be a different sun because they're of the ilk that believes we've shifted into another reality, which is not the case. Our reality is being messed with by the demonic and fallen angels and in league with men. But they filter the solar radiation with particulates in the atmosphere that have certain properties that affected our perception of the sunlight. So it filtered out those energies. Well, that changes the material world at large. It has a cascading effect, folks. Okay? So what we think about light, we've been taught wrong for generations. And light is not just something that we see with our eyes. And sunlight in particular, and there's another video I want to show you all, just a piece of it. Sunlight in particular affects how water functions. Okay? It literally affects the way water, how it functions in our realm, in our world, all right? And we're going to go back to the history, and I'm going to find it. It's called the fourth.
Right, as though nobody's watching.
Let me get past this commercial here.
Suspense is...
Check this out.
Thank you. Water is quite beautiful to look at, and I guess you probably all know that you're two-thirds water, but
you do, don't you?
Right. But you may not know that because the water molecule is so small, that two-thirds translates into 99% of your molecules. Think of it, 99% of your molecules are water. So do those, your shoes are carrying around a blob of water, essentially. Now, so question is, in your cell, do those, the thing ought to be known about water?
First of all, the guy gets up in a TED talk and says, your body, really 99% is how much your body's made up of what we call water, but not water in the general idea. And he's going to go on and explain a little more. Now, I can't turn the volume up any louder, the videos load. All right. So,
a lizard from the what you see.
Check this out. So, this video, I'm going to post a link to it. I'm going to download it, increase the level on the audio, and repost it. He also goes on to explain or pose the question, why is it that water here over the ocean? All this ocean is vaporizing. There's vapor rising up from the solar radiation. Why does it coagulate into this one single cloud over the ocean? Why is that? Or how is that? Right? And, oh, thanks, Paula.
Could you imagine droplets?
Oh, wait a minute. I saw, yeah, Landon, yes, you can post my email all over the place. Thanks. All right.
Water.
Check this out. Y'all see that? So now, water
We expect droplets to coalesce instantly with the water. The droplets persist for a long time.
See that again. Check it out.
The cloud sitting there.
Watch this.
And the water is evaporating everywhere. Why does it go to this cloud forming what you see there? So another question, could you imagine droplets floating on water?
Check that out. So, okay, there's this thing we call surface tension. And that is like, it's like a membrane of between the oxygen molecules of our air and the H2O of water. And there's this area, this separation area between the two. And that is what we call surface tension. So this fellow goes on to talk a little bit more about it. Now understand, let me just play it a little bit. You'll hear what he says.
We expect droplets to coalesce instantly with the water. The droplets persist for a long time. And then here's another example of walking on water. This is a lizard from Central America. And because it walks on water, it's called the Jesus Christ lizard.
Okay, so this freaking lizard is called a Jesus Christ lizard. That's not blasphemous on multiple levels, right? Yes. Now listen, we have spiders, really large, scary spiders here in South Carolina, on our pool every spring. These mama spiders got a bunch of little babies on their back, like hundreds, and they put air bubbles on their legs and can walk on the pool water. And I try to get them out of the pool, and yes, I kill them because I don't really like spiders, okay? At least not these. And every time, it's quite an experience. I stomp on the dag or get the spider out of the pool with the leaf scooper, and these little babies go all over the place. It's like something out of a scary movie. And I'm stomping on little spiders all over the place. Whatever. Is there a PETA, a version of PETA for spiders? You can call them on me. Go for it. All right.
And of course, you'll say, well, I know the answer to this. The surface tension is high on water. But the common idea of surface tension is that there's a single molecular layer of water at the top. And this single molecular layer is sufficient to create enough tension to hold whatever you put there. I think this is an example that doesn't fit that. And here's another example.
Check this out.
Two beakers of water. You put two electrodes in. And you put a high voltage between them. And then what happens is a bridge forms. And this bridge is made of water. A bridge of water.
Okay. Understand, these physical aspects of water did not exist before. We would have known about them. They would have been something. It would have been a common teaching. People would have talked about it. Understand. They did not exist. It exists now because physics in our world is changing because they began changing our sunlight by filtering out specific frequencies, which the way frequency filters work, is if you filter out one frequency, it increases the perceived amplitude, the volume, the strength, the loudness of all the other frequencies. Okay? So just by filtering out certain light aspects, it doesn't just change it in that one area. It increases the strength of all the other aspects of that light source. And in this case, we're talking about sunlight, which powers practically everything in this world. And they've been messing with that for decades. All right. And also, that's right, somebody just wrote it. I know it laws. Look, the meaning of the scripture now that says that they will think to change my laws and seasons, right? Or seasons and laws, whatever. It does, the way scripture is, it pertains to a multitude of things. This is God talking, and God is not linear in his manner. All right. So when God says something, it applies in a myriad of ways to all creation. And this is part of that. They are messing with what we call physical laws and changing our atmosphere, everything, the way things function. All right. Purposely. Now, if you go back and you look at what we used to call mythology, if you look at mythological lore, you'd had things like, you know, little fairies and things like, you know, things would just float. You know, they're recreating that same environment. It's packaged differently in these end of times, right? So that's what they're doing. And this is new stuff, guys. This is,
you move one beaker away from the other beaker.
I want to show you
as much as 4 centimeters. A famous physical chemist 100 years ago. Exactly.
So we have 4 phases of water now. Is the point of this video. Not 3. Okay. And he goes on to explain, and I'm going to post the video so you all can check it out for yourselves. It's a 24-minute long video that he goes on to explain that sunlight drives the function of how water works. We all know, hopefully you do, they've been messing with sunlight for a while. And so water, which makes up us a lot, if they're messing with water, they're changing the way we function as well. How many of you know that our organs are all shifted around, everything's changed, right? Okay. So I just wanted y'all to see this stuff because it's other things that are coming down the pike that we need to be aware of. All right. So we're going to get into Black Tom. I want to show you all. I got this item that I want to show. All right. I normally explain that the way this thing is happening is that they're changing the way light works. Light affects all of what we call the material world. That's how they're changing the words in our printed Bibles. That's how they're changing what we call reality. Okay? Light is the essence of everything. And so when they started changing the way light works, they changed the essence of everything. But when I say light, we're not talking about like the light that's coming from this light bulb over here. That's just a tiny portion of the entire, what we call EM spectrum. I've said this before. If this is the first time, I'll point you to some videos that I explain it a little more. Okay. So Black Tom. Those of you, if you've never listened to Brian Stavely, who talks about this quite a bit, because it's a huge deal, right? How many of us watched the buildings come down on 9/11? Right? We all watched the buildings come down. We sat there in stunned silence. I was in a room at NASA with a bunch of women around and other men, and the women were sobbing and the men were sitting there going, this is not freaking happening. And we watched, especially we sat there and watched the second building come down. Nobody was walking away from the TVs. We all watched, right? During those next few weeks, all we heard was a detailed explanation of how those buildings came down. Actually, about 20 minutes after the buildings came down, we heard a detailed explanation about, you know, well, obviously from the fuel, the metal melted in the building, you know, they gave us the whole spiel. And because we were in shock, right? We're in shock. Our minds were opened up to whatever we heard next as the answer. Because in our psyches, we were all searching, well, how in the hell is this happening, was pretty much the mantra for the day. So they trauma mind controlled the masses, right? Now, those of you who are in this gathering right now, you all probably know all of this already, but there are going to be other people that are going to come across this video and hear this. And I can picture right now in my mind people that think that what we're saying is crazy. You know, they think it's crazy that the government would do anything like this. Whatever. Okay. During those times, over and over again, we heard the only other time anybody was able to attack American soil was Pearl Harbor, the day that will live in infamy, right? Nobody ever heard about Black Tom. No one. Now, again, if you haven't watched Brian Stavely's stuff, I would invite you to go over to his channel, and somebody put Brian's channel in the list there, and Brian's got tons of stuff, but just a qualifier, Brian's the king of F-bombs, so just a, if you're offended by cussing, oh well. Still love you, dude. I don't care. Because, I mean, I cut my teeth in bar rooms, you know, between two topless joints. So, look. Black Tom. So, we've got all this backstory now on this thing called the Black Tom explosion. Right? And here's a picture right here. Y'all can see. And we'll zoom out here. Let's see if we can get it a little bigger. Right? And so it was, according to the story, if I can get, how do you get out of this now? There we go. It was an act of sabotage by German agents to destroy U.S.-made munitions that were supplied to the Allies in World War I. Okay. So it was like 5.5 on the Richter scale, this explosion on Black Tom Island, which is off of New Jersey, right? Y'all see that, right? So in my reality, in most of our realities, this never freaking happened, right? Now, I've been telling everyone for some time now that it is a small matter for AI to concoct a storyline, the news, a backstory, even put age on it, like, you know, have this story have existed for 20 years. That's if we're going online looking up our information, it's nothing for AI to fabricate everything, including people walking around and having conversations. I mean, in all honesty, AI could be fabricating me right now. This could be AI you're watching. I'm not. I swear I'm not. Great. Now I just incepted you all. Anyway, I'm not a crook. Where have you heard that before? Anyway, so look. Got a story here. This is pretty cool. An attack that turned out to be a German terrorism has a modest legacy 100 years later. There's that same picture. Okay. Talks about the same thing. This is another thing that the media does very well, and AI also does very well, is to repeat the same story at different places until it's been said so many times that it becomes reality in the minds of the people. Right? The explosion on Black Tom Island, a 25-acre promontory jutting from Jersey City that was built from New Yorkers' garbage, registered an estimated 5.5 on the Richter scale, 30 times more powerful than that of the collapse of the World Trade Center 85 years later, where we never, ever, ever heard of it mentioned. I mean, come on now. They would have mentioned it, folks. Right. It was considered the most destructive terrorist attack in America until September 11th. Again, we never heard about it. We never heard about Black Tom. ever. All right. So, shells recovered by divers here, right, after the attack. That's another thing that Stavely talks about that's freaking huge off the coast of North Carolina. What's it called? Torpedo Alley. Crazy town time, folks. This stuff didn't freaking exist. Okay, so my take on all of this is that it is of no real consequence, no effort for AI to fabricate all of these stories, have them repeat. You understand? No humans are in on the story. It doesn't even matter if it puts real people's names to it. Okay? Even the videos, it's nothing. I've shown this before. Hopefully I don't have to get into it now. Is AI can create people that don't exist, right? So, I came across, where is it at? You're going to love this, folks. I came across this book. Sabotage at Black Tom. I was doing a little research. Actually, I was listening to Stavely and some of his guests, and they were talking about these events. And this was kind of noodling around. So the dude who wrote this book, his name is Jules Whitcover. Pay attention to the names. Not that that really has any meaning in my mind right now, but still kind of curious, right? We can visit his page. So this dude has written all of these books, according to Amazon. It could be a real guy, whatever, okay? So what do I do? I ordered a book, and that's what we're going to open right now. I haven't opened the box myself, and so I was tempted to order the book and send it to Stavely just to see what his reaction would be. But we're going to open this book together, have a little discovery together, okay? We're going to talk about the Jews now. All right, check it out. Here's the book. I did cut the tape because I didn't want to have to fight with the tape tonight, okay? So here we go. We're going to open this book. And all nicely packaged. Taped up again inside here. It's actually a hardcover with a sleeve over top of it. We're going to set the box aside. It's in plastic wrap. Of course, it's taped up like a sieve here. Wait a minute. Yeah, I love surprises sometimes too. So my hope was is that I ordered the book and they were going to send me a notification that the book is out of stock. Right? So it comes in the mail today. So this on the surface looks like it kills my AI story, right? On the surface. Doesn't that kill my AI as manufacturing all this crap? Or is it possible that this is still just manufactured? What's the published date? Well, we're going to check it out, dude. We're going to open this thing up. We're going to check it out. So, it says it's a collectible from WinGrab Books. See that? Actually, I think I can show y'all right here. Y'all can see it, right? So we're gonna reveal this book on Black Tom together. You know what's funny? Oh, I had another thing I wanted to show too. I spend a couple of bucks once in a while when I want to prove something. This stuff costs me money. Oh, I got a little bookmark thing from the company. And a thank you note. And according to Amazon, I don't see. Oh, 1989. Hardcover, May 1989. Okay. So, it looks pretty good, huh? Nice looking book. In Germany, Imperial Germany's Secret War in America. Wow. Sabotage at Black Tom. A book. This thing is clean, too, dude. You know what sucks is it sold for $19.95 and I paid $25 for it. Man, whatever. Well, that might have been with shipping. So here's the dude. Here's the writer. He's a native of Union City, New Jersey. Anybody tempted to go knock on the dude's door? Because I am. Because quite frankly, I would... That's about how far I would be willing to go to find out what's the deal with this, right? So he's a graduate of Columbia College and the Columbia Graduate School of Journalism. He's like a serious writer, syndicated columnist, all this crap. I read about him already. So this part in the sleeve is not a surprise to me. What I was hoping is I'd get the book and it would be blank pages or something. So check it out, man. Talks about the sabotage at Black Tom, a book published. I'm going to check out on all the publishers and everything. Okay. Someplace Algonquin Books, something Algonquin Books of Chapel Hill. I believe that's in New Jersey. And, 1989. Wow. Pretty fascinating. He dedicates it to Bob and Mary. Wild, huh? So who lives near New Jersey that you all can go knock on the door for him? Maybe, hey, you could show up with a big cardboard check. Okay. What's this? Humble Pie. Huh. I guess that was a drawing they put out back then. Wow. Check it out. What's he say? Vox. Right. That's right. That's right. I saw that piece. That's what you were showing. So, all of this. Okay. So, what are we to think? Because, I mean, this kind of trashes some of my theories about how that everything that we're seeing is completely a fabrication. I mean, this is pretty hard right here. How do you deny I'm holding a daggone hardcover book with all kinds of images? Hard copy, right? Pretty wild. I mean, this is the level we've got to go, right? Huh. Fascinating. So anyway, I'm not going to sit here and look through it tonight, but it's got all the pictures of the dudes who did the bombing. All that crap. I'll tell you what we probably need to look for now. Because I have a book. Where is it at? Let me find it. Here we go. I have this book. The Story of the Statue of Liberty. It's like a little kid's history book. And nowhere in it does it mention that the arm was damaged. And it goes through like the entire, all the refabs, everything. This book goes, I got this book and I set it aside looking, I was like, okay, is it going to talk about the arm being damaged, right? And nowhere does it mention it, ever. Talks about the construction, all that stuff. Now, you know, understand, because of Black Tom, supposedly no one's ever walked up in the torch, the hand, the arm of the Statue of Liberty because of the damage from Black Tom. So, pretty crazy town time, folks, isn't it? So, yeah, here's the book. It's a little kiddie book, you know, little history book. Cornerstones of Freedom, the Story of the Statue of Liberty. And I went through this thing over and over again. And nowhere does it mention it. It's actually a pretty neat little summary of the history of how the statue came to get to be where it's at and all that stuff. Okay, so I see a lot of comments. Jesus is what matters. Yes, yes, of course. He's the way, the truth, and the life. But there's another scripture that says that we should not be unaware of the wiles of our enemy, the devil, lest he may gain an advantage over you, okay, or over us. So, this is spiritual warfare, folks. It's spiritual warfare. Yes, right on, Brian. People call you. You should ask them if you can record the conversation. It's funny, though. What sucks is people will tell you the truth, but then they're afraid to actually be recorded and be accountable for what they know is the truth. A bunch of crap. And, oh, here you go. Check this out. This is a picture right here. In the 1940s, people inside the Crown is covered with graffiti. So they did graffiti even. They probably didn't have taggers back then, right? 1940s dude with his can of spray paint. Here you go. Right here in this picture. By the 1970s, many parts of the statue, including the torch, were in desperate need of repair. Wouldn't it have said, hey, you know, because of damage from Black Tom? The Uncle Sam inside the Black Tom book had a striped hat. Hey, that'd be cool. Where? You saw that? Let me see. That's cool. Good catch. Looks like it. That's great, man. There you go. Just got my $25 worth. That's great. Whatever. Freaking crazy town time. Okay, well, here's one where he doesn't. Check that crap out. So what's up with that? I don't know, folks. This stuff is tripping me out. So that was my big surprise. Hopefully I haven't let you all down. I was hoping Stavely would come though, because I, you know, got the freaking hardback cover book. Man. I'm gonna contact this writer. I mean, I fully intend to contact the writer and get a little feedback. Hey, maybe we should have him on the show. That'd be cool. Because I'm sure, you know, most history writers probably don't get a lot of traffic, right? I'm just saying. We aren't going to do a book reading. David Wolfe. That's all right. We can show that. All right. Yes, it is crazy crap. So, That's all I wanted to talk about tonight. I just wanted to show, let everybody know, if you hadn't noticed, there was a new wave of quantum effect changes. And, although I've been suggesting that all of it is due, this throws a little bit of a wrench in it. I can actually, though, it really does throw a wrench in it. This is over the top. A historic event that never existed, and now writers that I'm buying a book from on the historic event. Maybe we contact the guy and he never wrote the book. That would be sweet. We'll find out, right? I assure you, if I do call him and I have a conversation with him, it's going to be recorded, folks. Yeah. They are beefing up the backstories on all the big ones. You're right. In the last 2 months, all of a sudden now we've got more of a backstory. You've got a monument at Liberty Island, where the Statue of Liberty is, for Black Tom, which is freaking crazy, right? Black Tom Monument. I mean, come on. And oh, and that was another funny thing too, is Black Tom Monument. I'll show it. Show the screen. Display on right. There we go. Images for Black Tom Memorial, Jersey City, New Jersey. There we go. Yeah, and they actually here it is. This is ridiculous right here. This is supposedly a bottle. Where's that? There it is. That is a melted bottle from Black Tom. Now think about this, folks. Really? Really? They're going to put a melted bottle at the memorial, at their museum. I don't know. I just thought that was kind of stupid. There it is. There's the Statue of Liberty in the background, right? Yeah, very interesting times. Explosion at Liberty. Interesting. It didn't say at Black Tom. It said at Liberty. On July 30th, 1916, Black Tom Munitions Depot exploded. Yep. Fascinating. Anyway, so that's about it for me. I just wanted to show you all the book. Show you all that this stuff is crazier, over the top. No, it's which one is a joke? TDC Radio says this is a joke. Star Fort. Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah. Yeah. Are you talking about the Foundation for Liberty? Star Fort? Yeah, okay. Yeah, yeah. Yeah, that's crazy. I know it is. Yeah, there. Look at that. Look, there you go. You can't see it because I'm not showing it on the screen. Look at that, folks. Really? Come on. And look at this. This is from 2016. Big Jim and Black Tom. An Irishman's diary about an attack on America in 1916. Look at the foundation. It was never like that, folks. That is crazy. Whatever. Just no telling what you're going to see next. Oh, I'll tell you, though, one of the things that I have said in the whole thing with the water. You heard it here first, folks. You're going to see water fall upwards. I don't know what that means. The Holy Spirit told me this about a year or two ago. It might have been 2 years. We're going to see water fall upwards. And that's going to be a sign. Okay. All right, folks. We're going to get out of here. It's 11:11. How appropriate. And Big Jim. Oh, Big Jim's probably the Irishman's diary, you know. Yeah, that's what that's about. See? Big Jim and Black Tom. It was some Irishman's diary. He wrote a diary about it. Yeah, I'll tell you, like I said, before I got this hard copy book, I mean, it's very difficult to make a claim that AI and the changes on our material realm is what all is. When I just got shipped a book, it's throwing a wrench, right, in it all. So, right. Anyway, well, we're going to close out in our usual benediction. And I thank you all for showing up tonight. Let's give a shout out to some folks real quick. Who's in? Atheism is Madness, Benjamin Montion, Bill Stegman, Bob D. Stavely. Brian Stavely's up. Check out his channel, folks. Carla Redpill, Ceiling Fan Man. That's cool. Charles Mills, Colin Rose, D Bird, Data Junkie, David Wolf, Diana Oddman with the wrench, Green Eggs and Ham, Sam I Am. Happy Smiles, Harbinger of the Harvest, dude. Someday we are going to get together and talk live. Jay Hood. Harbinger's got some great stuff on his channel. He doesn't have a lot of stuff, but it's really cool. A great testimony. I think I posted on my channel, as a matter of fact. Jay Hood, Jeff Ray, Jeremy Cox, John Roberts, Josh from Oregon. What's up? Karen Ann Preston, Lord Help Us Tampa, Margaret Walter, Michelangelo, Nada, Nada, Ned Sellers, Paula D, Pyridoxine Oxide, that's probably something flammable, Rain on the Plains, Rain Cry, 527, Reality Dose, Cerebral Snarfle, Rom, Sparky OG, Susan Havens, Susan McCormick, TDC, what's up, dude? TDC Radio, check his stuff out, folks. Tesla's Enthusiasm, Tex Edwards, Like God Sea Warrior, The Word and Truth, Tommy Rogers, Tony S., welcome, with a wrench. Trisha C., West Cleveland Original, and Whitney, 3377XXX. By the way, if you don't know, you can... Right, you can click or mouse over a person's name and visit their channel in the chat. Okay, so if you don't know that already, that's you don't have to ask, well, how do I get to their channel? It's right there, plain as day. Go to channel, you click on the dot dot dots, and you're good to go, folks. So, anyway, my usual benediction is God marks you, or I speak this blessing. It's God's mark or his name. We put his name upon you, and God does the blessing. And it's in the Hebrew, Yavareh Kaka Adonai VeYishme Raka. Ya'er Adonai Penevaleka VeYusamleka. Oh man, I cannot believe I'm actually doing this. I just thought about hitting the switch and tripped up what I'm saying. Sorry, folks. It's a weird night. Let me start over. Yavareh Kaka Adonai VeYishme Raka. Ya'er Adonai Penevaleka VeHuneka. Yisa Adonai Penevaleka VeYusamleka. Shalom. Peace. In Jesus' name.
I wanna say to my sisters and my brothers, keep the faith when the storm flies and the wind blows. Go on at a steady pace. When the battle is fought and the victory's won, we can all shout together, we have overcome. We'll talk to the Father and the Son when we make it to the promised land. Walk together, little children. We don't ever have to worry. Through this world of trouble, we gotta love one another. Let us take a fellow man by the hand. Try to help him to understand. We can all be together forever and ever when we make it to the promised land. Our Bible reads, thou shalt not be afraid of the terror by night, nor the arrow that flies by day. No, for the pestilence that walketh in the darkness, nor for the destruction that waiteth in the noonday hour. Walk together, little children.